Greetings, YouTubers. The following video is done as a satire comedic skit. The idea is to give you a fair review of Virry VR and how they actually view you, the customers. So, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Virry VR Review. So today I decided I'm going to fire up my PlayStation 4 video gaming rig. And I decided I was going to log into the lovely PlayStation store and find cheap VR. You know, I always like my cheap VR because some of the cheapest VR can be sometimes the funnest things. Not in this case. So I went into the store, I went into the PSVR section, and I downloaded Virry VR. Now, it's interesting. I bought Virry for $1.99. I wasn't expecting a lot out of it. I mean, really, for $1.99, you would honestly expect it to be a pile of garbage. But I couldn't realize that it's not only a pile of garbage, it's a flaming cow pie. You know, like those cow pies that you just can't get out of your boots, no matter how hard you try. Well, that's what this is. So I downloaded Virry Safari. Oh, wait a minute. It's supposed to be downloading Virry VR. Why in the hell does the store pronounce it as Virry VR and the actual application you're downloading is Virry Safari? I mean, I've heard of bait and switch, but I guess it's what they do. So I downloaded it. If you're wondering, Virry VR is a 360-degree view of animals out in the wild that you can view, and it's designed to help for conservationists and things like that to make money for conservation of these wild animals that are in danger. And I thought, oh great, it'd be a great idea to download this. It's only $1.99. And why not? It supports a good cause. Then I decided I'm going to start this thing up. It was made by Fountain Digital Labs Limited. It takes nearly 8.42 gigs of hard drive space. And I thought, okay, it's not a bad download. It might be interesting. I started the thing up. And the first thing the dumb ass software basically tells me is this your first time in Virry VR? Have you ever used the software before? My basic thought of that is, you really think that I'm fucking stupid and I have the IQ of a turnip? Because obviously that's exactly what you think if you're going to ask somebody, is this your first time in the software and your software can look for a save file and detect whether it's your first time in the software or not? Instead of asking an annoying butt question of, is this your first time in here? Sorry, I really hated that. You know what? No, it's not my first time in here. I watched your mama play it last night. Would that be better? So I was angry about that. And then they did the most annoying thing. Have you ever heard about those narrators? You know, you get a good narrator that can narrate something, and then you get a narrator that's just gonna put you to sleep. I mean, you literally are just gonna fall asleep in the cow pies and everything else because this lady that they get as a navigator doesn't work well. Well, I decided that, oh my gosh, this lady is gonna drive me to my grave. I'm sitting there and we get this British sounding lady and she's like, is this your first time in Virry VR? This is how you access things and move around and stuff like that. I was like, okay. So I picked up my patented controller, and to start this weird piece of software, you have to press R1 and R2, or, sorry, L1 and R2 together to basically start the software. Now, that's stupid. Why can't I just press the start button like everybody else? Do you really think that we are that uneducated and we do not have a high enough education that we actually have to use other buttons instead of the start button, which every person knows how to use on a video game console? Obviously, Virry VR's creators did not bother thinking about that. And they obviously didn't think about that we actually have a brain and are actually smarter than we sound. They just basically all thought that we're dumbass hicks that don't know our butts from a pigsty. And that really angered me right there, is that, wow, yeah, didn't think we knew how to use a start button. So I thought it couldn't get any worse. Literally any worse. Really? Really? Boy, was I wrong. I went into the options section. Because the first thing I wanted to do was turn off the British sounding lady. She could put anybody to sleep. The first thing I did was the lions. And the only thing I wanted to do was to fall asleep in my VR headset because she was the most annoying pain in the butt to listen to in this software, ladies and gentlemen. So then I thought, okay, this is going to get bad. Then I noticed major glitches while watching the lion. And first major glitch was the lion gets right in the path of the camera lens where they're joining two video sequences to each other. I'm sure you heard how a 360-degree video works. It's when there are segments of the video and they are stitched together to create a 360-degree view. Well, this program was done so cheaply and arrogantly They basically did a dum-dum, and the dum-dum that they did was they didn't properly stitch the video together. So the lion goes from lion to spider lion in less than 5 seconds. And when I mean spider lion, the lion ends up magically growing 4 sets of eyeballs and literally looking like a spider. Because the lion gets stuck in between 2 frames of the camera, and when you're looking around in VR, you catch it out of the corner of your eye, and it scares the ever-loving crap out of you. This is a simple thing that could have been fixed by a good quality camera, but obviously they're not capable of doing that because they think that they're intelligent, and they aren't. So let's keep going, ladies and gentlemen. So I decided, okay, I can turn her off in options. But I can't turn off the stupid trivia inside. So every single time I'm not listening to her because I have her turned off, a stupid trivia window comes up. And the trivia window that comes up basically asks you trivia questions. Now here's the hard part in all of this garbage. How are you going to answer a trivia question when the annoying bimbo navigator that's talking to you is no longer talking to you? You should have the option to turn off the trivia and just enjoy the experience with some music or something that makes it fun and innovative. If I wanted to go back to school and get myself a high school education, I would have done so, and I would have gone there. Instead, you basically build this software and treat everybody like they're an elementary school kitty playing on an old Macintosh SE30 controlling a laser disc. It's about as much fun as polishing a cow turd. It's annoying that they actually thought that this was a good piece of software. And if you wonder why I'm talking like this, it's because they actually think people are ignorant dumb shits and don't freaking know what the hell they're talking about. And they view that everybody should learn more about these animals, even though that we have learned about these animals in elementary school. And they feel that it's a good idea for these people to learn about these animals like they're an elementary school student. Now, I'm sorry, but when an adult buys a VR title to experience something new and innovative, the last thing we want to be treated like is a 6.5-year-old kid wiping his butt with a leaf outside in the woods. And here you are, treating us like elementary school students. I'm sorry, but you could have at least got something better to navigate the dang frickin' system. I go into options, and I try to leave options. I can't leave options. I literally have to reset the sucker to go back to the main menu. So here I am again, ladies and gentlemen, pressing R1, L1. And I have to bring up the darn menu again. And that darn menu, I have to reset every time I want to leave options. There's no back key. So I'm like, this is the stupidest crud ever. Then I started noticing some other fuddly problems. Virry VR receives live images from Africa via the internet and a server. So when you're on the main menu inside Virry VR, Virry Safari, I should say, because they changed the name and can't change it in the goddamn store. Basically, they decided it was a good idea to basically have this connect to a server and transmit images to the software. Well, that sounds wonderful until you realize, uh-oh, the software is no longer supported and the server's gone. How the heck are you going to access that background image? Oops. Guess they never thought that one through. So, I keep finding tons of interesting and weird things with this software. The weirdest last thing that I found in this software is in the friends and community section for Virry Safari. For some odd reason, there are two community groups. Both of these groups are in Italian. Neither of them are in US, English, UK, or English, US. So I created one called Virry VR US Group. And I created one because there isn't anybody else in there creating a group for U.S. owners of this god-awful piece of education software. So I decided I'm going to flat out make one. And I finally had somebody join the group. So I'm glad there's at least two of us in there. At least we can have fun talking about how dumb some of the aspects of this piece of crap are. So that's exactly why I'm talking like this. Because Fountain Digital Labs Limited thinks that we're all ignorant hicks that don't know 3 feet from our hole in the ground about animals, and they decided to build a trivia game inside an experience that should have just been video and animals, and they would have actually been able to keep the price tag of it at $10. Now it's $1.99 for PlayStation Plus subscribers, and I recommend don't buy it, because even at $1.99, this still ain't worth jack-navy crap to support conservation. they easily could have gone through, they could have easily have removed the trivia and allowed you to turn off the British sounding, pardon my language, bitch. Thank you. Do not pick this up. This is a worthless title. Thank you for enjoying this satirical comedy. The idea is to basically show how stupid this manufacturer truly thought we are. They thought that we're all elementary kid students that need education on these animals, and we need to answer trivia questions. It plays like an old Laserdisc game. For people who grew up in the 80s and 90s and remember those huge expensive Laserdiscs that they used to send out with edumacation software trials, and I call them edumacation because they were education Laserdiscs that communicated directly to a Mac SE30, and you could sit there and answer questions in trivia, and it would play the video on the TV screen and all this other great crap when you were growing up. And I'm sure you all remember this. And the reason why this never took off is because of all the trivia crap. It basically drove kids away from history. It drove kids away from learning about animals and stuff like this. Because when you have to answer a trivia question, it basically makes it feel like an elementary piece of software. This thing is garbage. For $1.99, I could have spent way more money. And the creepy thing that I ran into was one of the community groups that's attached to Virry Safari, aka Virry VR, is an Italian group that's locked. Understand this, it's a locked community group to talk about Virry Safari. Now, I'm sorry, but Virry Safari is about animals. So to have them lock something that's about animals and lock it to an Italian chat room, that pretty much really makes me wonder, are they talking about actual animals in the sense of, hey, let's talk about the software? Or are they talking about animals in a sexual sense? And this absolutely made me want to barf and upchuck that you would lock down a community. Why would you lock down a community? Think about that. You trying to hide something? So that's why I created Virry VR US group. It's in there. It's one of mine. If you buy Virry, just be prepared for the worst experience you're ever going to experience. Navigating a menu. Stupid as hell. Why can't I just press the start button? Why do I have to press the stupid top buttons on the controller? Second off, why the hell can't I just use the circle key to go back to the previous menu? Oh, I'm sorry, you're not allowed to do that. You gotta press the top buttons again. Reset the dang freaking menu. It's things like this that are stupid, dumb, and ignorant in this software. That was the reason for the whole opening sequence of this video. Is they basically think that we are all jackasses with an elementary school education and we need to learn like we're 2.5 years old. Doesn't work. Sorry. Virry is a worthless pile of garbage. Just stay away. Thank you.